understand how dark it is, how far down the line we are, how late it is?
Now, continuing on the health subject, we are joined right now by Dr. Ed Group from Global Healing Center. Ed, thanks for joining me today.
It's great to be on. I'm a big fan of the show.
You are, yeah. You listen to Alex Jones quite a lot.
I've been listening to Alex Jones for years and been involved in, you know, the eugenics of what's going on with the population. And, you know, when you ask me to speak about aluminum, it's crazy the amount of aluminum people are exposed to right now, especially since they're spraying about 20 million tons of it in the air. And they're spraying a nanoparticles of aluminum, and that's actually converting or taking away the natural ozone that cleanses the air. And the reason why those chemtrails start looking white is because it converts to aluminum oxide, and now it's coming down and falling all over the snow, so the rain, everything.
There's a geoengineering agenda here that InfoWars has exposed, and Aaron Dykes did some great work on that. But with you here, let's talk about the health implications. First, what are the main sources of aluminum toxicity? And then let's get into the detox strategies that really work.
Well, the main source of aluminum toxicity is coming from the air now, too. You can also inhale it from the shower. When you take a shower through the water, you can inhale it just out by the sea because it's mixing with the salt water. If you notice, they're spraying over the oceans right now because the aluminum mixes with the salts and gets into everything else. But deodorant, lipstick, hemorrhoid products, baking powder. Anytime you go to a restaurant, you eat any type of bread, anything that has to be baked, most likely it has aluminum in it. Aluminum cans that people drink out of, even any type of food wrapping that's wrapped in aluminum. And I was talking about even going to purchase organic foods, and the organic foods and drinks still have aluminum linings in them. So
what we have here, for those on the radio, we have a bar, a food bar with an aluminum lining.
Yes.
And this is an organic bar of some
kind?
That
is a certified organic bar.
So we can still have aluminum even if it's organic.
So we still have aluminum. Yes, we do. And all the cans that are aluminum that are still coated with BPA.
Oh, yeah.
They still have
a double dose.
That, so it's a double dose. Yes.
What else you have there? What other containers?
This was a coconut water, an organic coconut water that has a aluminum lining in it as well. So I mean, even
show
when
that
you
on camera.
Think that you're not getting any aluminum in your system, that you're doing good and you're eating organic and you're buying all kinds of organic foods, you still have to understand that you're probably most likely going to be exposed to aluminum.
We got to clean this up afterwards, or Alex is going to think a pack of ravenous wolves came through his office and just started shredding food and leaving wrappers everywhere. Wrappers on the desk. But no, you're exactly right, Ed. Wrappers can have it. You mentioned deodorants. That's another one that a lot of people don't know. But if you look at conventional deodorants, there's an aluminum ingredient right there on the label.
Yes. Aluminum breast cancer has actually gone up because women put aluminum deodorants in the spray aerosol aluminum deodorant.
Right.
You can actually breathe it in, too, but the aluminum goes straight in, and aluminum is a neurotoxin. One strange thing is aluminum, when it mixes with mercury, if you were to take a drop of mercury and put some aluminum shavings on it, it has a violent reaction.
Really? Can we try that?
I would love to try that.
Is it right here?
A video on it that you can actually watch and watch the reaction. But when you have mercury in your mouth and then you're putting aluminum in, or you have mercury in your body and it's going up to your brain and it's mixing with aluminum, cadmium, lead, all the other heavy metals, you know, who knows what type of reactions are taking place and how damaging that is to the body.
Well, I mentioned that here on a previous show, that much of America today is poisoned with heavy metals and the lighter metals like aluminum. But there's so much brain poisoning that exists today. No wonder people can't realize that Ron Paul makes sense. You know, enough people. I mean, everybody should realize that we don't want another war. Everybody should realize that we want to control our own money supply and not have the Fed printing trillions of dollars and giving them out to the banksters. I mean, why, you know, do you agree that part of the metals poisoning explains the insanity?
It's already been proven. I mean, look at the kids that are being diagnosed with autism or attention deficit disorder or hyperactivity disorder. I mean, when you link all the metals together, they're neurological degraders, and it can mess with your thought patterns. It can cause depression. It can cause everything else to happen. I mean, there was a recent interview with teachers all across the United States, and they said that two-thirds to three-quarters of all the students have a chronic respiratory infection and cough right now.
Really?
Yes. The amount of aluminum has gone up from 2006 when they did analysis on the snow water at Mount Shasta. They found about 1,000 micrograms per liter of aluminum. In late 2009, they did a study again. They found 61,000 micrograms per liter of aluminum in the snow water. And the safe level is 0.5 micrograms per liter.
Oh, that's insane.
And the government is supposed to be called for emergency action if any aluminum is found at 1,000 micrograms or more. So that's 60 times the emergency level, and they still haven't been called in.
What is the agenda behind the aluminum poisoning? I mean, do you think that there's something going on here? There's a reason they're spraying it into the atmosphere. There's a reason they're putting it into the food supply. It's in more soils now than ever before, you know, like added on. In fact, through, you know, toxic fertilizers.
Well, it's amazing that the FDA has a GRAS rating for aluminum, generally recognized as safe, and there's over 2,000 adverse effects listed at the Natural Museum or the Library of Medicine, 2,000 adverse effects. I think it has to do with eugenics and continually degrading the immune system, because aluminum takes away the absorption of zinc and selenium. Zinc and selenium are both used to boost the immune system. That's why you're seeing such a deficiency in zinc from people. But also, Monsanto, their seeds, some of their seeds are resistant to metals. And
right.
Exactly. So if you can kill off, and pH levels for that matter. So what's happening is the pH of soil is increasingly getting higher.
More alkaline,
and you're seeing a destruction of crops. So what's going to happen with all this spraying eventually is you're going to see a decreased crop production, thereby leading to farmers having to buy seeds that are
from Monsanto,
you know,
and DuPont,
resistant to mercury, aluminum, and pH level.
All right. Folks, you're listening to an interview here on The Alex Jones Show with Dr. Edward Group from Global Healing Center. The website is globalhealingcenter.com, just like it sounds. And he's a great formulator of detox solutions, many things there. I want to ask your opinion, Ed, on this new story today from naturalsociety.com by Anthony Gucciardi. Scientists say we should delay breastfeeding to improve vaccine potency. Get this, that mothers should not breastfeed anymore because the breastfeeding is interfering with the vaccines. And this is published in the Journal of Pediatric Infections and Diseases. I'm not making this up. I'm not trying to hoax you right here on the air. What do you think about that?
Well, I've been a long-term believer that vaccines don't do anything but destroy the body. I mean, anytime you give a child a vaccination before their immune system is fully developed, before they're 11 or 12 years old, all it's going to do is completely wreak havoc. And then you add in all of the spermicides and the thimerosal and all the other vaccination contaminants, all you're doing is completely shutting that person down. So, I mean, that right there is just...
That's insane.
It's insane. I mean, you know, the way that they're pushing the flu shots, the way that they're talking about universal flu shots, I mean, all of it interacts together, and it's just designed to completely lower or knock out your immune system, and all it does is create more negative health conditions. And the poor children, I mean, you know, these are the main recipients that are suffering, and... They don't know. I mean, if you ask a child, if you were able to communicate with a child and say, hey, can I put this shot in you? What do you think they would do? They would scream. That's why you see children screaming, because they know intuitively that it's bad for them. And then
right.
Parents,
it hurts.
Put the vaccines in them anyway.
Okay, a couple more things, excuse me, that I want your input on. Excuse me. Sorry about that. A doctor calls police and child services on a mother who refuses to vaccinate her son. This was published on Infowars.com. Rachel Garman, who said, I don't want to vaccinate my child, got the state troopers called on her. This is happening over and over again. They want to have mandatory vaccine trial participation where you can't say no. You're being automatically volunteered to be in the vaccine trial. Now they want women to stop breastfeeding because it's interfering with the vaccine. And then we have this other story over here. This poor child was given 9 vaccines and died within a matter of days. I mean, how criminal is this? I mean, these are crimes that we're looking at.
And the fact that the government came up with a bill that vaccine companies are not going to be held liable for any damage. So, I mean,
right, of course.
About it?
Of course.
I mean, you know, the best thing we can do is just continue to to educate people about the damaging effects of vaccinations and what they can do to avoid them. And hopefully one day, you know, people will join together and we'll be able to stop all these chemicals and stop all these vaccinations from being injected into people. And we won't have to worry about our children, you know, growing up with decreased immune systems or the risk of developing some sort of disease early on in life, cancer or neurological disease. I mean, they're trying to dumb the children down by cutting down all these neurological pathways. And if you look at the way mercury reacts on neurons, it literally destroys the covering of the nerves, melts it away.
All right. Now, we promised the listeners that we would get into some solutions. And you're an expert on that. In fact, you are probably the expert on detox of heavy metals and BPA and things like that. What can you tell people that is practical that they can start doing now to either avoid absorbing aluminum or to get aluminum out that they may have already absorbed?
Well, yes, we've specialized in detoxing everything. I've been detoxing Gulf War Syndrome stuff, Corexit, I mean, you name it. But the main thing is the best and fastest way is to avoid any aluminum. Get rid of your aluminum cookware, stop drinking out of aluminum cans, stop using aluminum deodorant, switch to natural makeup. You don't use aluminum-based baking powder. And then what's worked the best for us is a mixture of a purified zeolite, fulvic acid, or humic acid, which contains 15 times the amount of receptors than EDTA does.
Really?
And what most people don't know is detoxified iodine is extremely effective at detoxing not only aluminum, but other aluminum is not necessarily a heavy metal, but other heavy metals like mercury, cadmium, fluoride, those toxins as well. Detoxified iodine will immediately excrete those from the system. If you have a far infrared sauna, that's another good thing. Modified citrus pectin, cilantro, chlorella, those are all different types of substances that we use in a super concentrated extract.
So most of those, I mean, that's all orally taken, so it's pretty easy for people.
It's very easy. And right now, with the amount of chemicals and metals that we're seeing in people and children, it's almost to the point where you have to take something at least once a week to keep the metals or the contaminants or chemicals out of your
body. What about bentonite clay? A lot of people talk about clay absorbing metals. Is that, but clay, some clay can have aluminum in it.
Exactly. Exactly. Some clay can have aluminum and other metals in it. It's not a bad way to detox. You can make an apple cider vinegar with Himalayan crystal salt bath and put some clays in there if you really need to suck it out through the skin, a hot bath, but then make sure that you use a shower filter or some sort of water filter because you're going to be putting the chemicals from the tap water into the shower,
right,
which are going to include some of the same chemicals you're trying to get rid of.
I want to also be really clear to those scientists who are listening. They will probably point out, you know, aluminum is one of the most common elements in the Earth's crust, along with zinc, for example. Aluminum is very common. You know, it's in the soils. But what we're talking about here is, you know, you can get aluminum in foods. There's a little bit of aluminum in a tomato, for example, or a sweet potato. But that's organically bound aluminum, which has been processed by plants. And you're not going to absorb that in the same way that you have an inorganic aluminum, a sort of an industrialized, you know, raw aluminum from ore that's being sprayed in the atmosphere and you know, and put in deodorant and other things. I mean, there are different types of aluminums in a sense. I mean, different levels of reactions biochemically.
Yes. I mean, the raw aluminum can be processed in many different types, aluminum oxide, nanoparticles of aluminum, aluminum hydroxide, aluminum sulfate, many different things. I mean, toothpaste contains it. There's just so many items now that come in contact with it. But like you said, anything that's taken from the earth that's synthetically manufactured into some other form or compound that can be patented and that can be sold or used for destructive methods, that's what's happening with aluminum.
Well, you also got to look at the history of mercury. You know, mercury was used as medicine for a very long period of time, and people would take mercury, and because of the inflammatory side effects, they would feel great for a little while. I mean, they would get erections from taking mercury, and they thought it was like the Vioxx of the 1800s. I mean, not the Vioxx. What's the Viagra? Sorry, yeah. I guess I got to get my drug vocabulary a little better filled in there. I don't use them, so I don't say the names every day. But Viagra of the 1800s was mercury.